Hello, Dissenters. My name is Etalyx, and I am here today with another Minecraft creation spotlight to show you. Today, we're going to be taking a look at a cathedral, and this is the Cathedral of Ardrane, and it is by an author named Notux, or Notux. As usual, once per Minecraft episode, we must mispronounce the name of the author of whatever it is we are covering. But it is a beautiful, wonderful creation, and I'm going to show it to you here in this video, inside and out, and all around it. But first, I want to take time to address the last episode, where we covered Corsair's Refuge, and the response was overwhelmingly positive. So my final rating for that, based on your scores, as well as my own personal opinion, is a 5 out of 5. But now, moving back on to today's project. What you're going to be seeing here is the culmination of 3 weeks of work. 3 weeks of work. Long time for a single Minecraft creation, but it does look very exquisite. It looks royal, doesn't it? We're heading into the inside of the cathedral right now, and there is a Dwarf King at the end of it, which you will see here in a minute, one of the many statues surrounding this particular cathedral. You'll probably notice some dragons around the outside. They appear to be statues, but there is one floating in the air, so I don't know if that one's supposed to be, like, real. I don't know what the backstory of this particular building is, but the design work is really, really good. I love the use of these diamond blocks everywhere. The designs are just really, really nice. The architecture is superb. The texture pack that you're seeing featured in this video to show off this beautiful creation is in fact a modified version of the DokuCraft or Garudoku texture packs, and it's been modified to change the ores and wools and things like that into more building blocks so that there can be more variety when constructing objects as grand as this one. But if you want to check it out for yourself, maybe to look at more builds by these authors and authors in the Creative Node line of builders, then you can do so in the description of this video. I've provided links to both this build as well as the texture pack below. So take a look at that if you so desire to take a look around for yourself, maybe see this in more detail than I'm showing you here in this video. Now, taking a look back outside, we are at the back of the cathedral right now, taking a look at the angel statue that overlooks the horizon behind it. And it is a very, very nice looking statue. Once we get a little bit further back, you'll be able to see it in greater detail. And there are two angel statues here amongst the dragons. This one is the nice angel. It's got the blue diamond cross on it, but we'll take a look at the Angel of Death here in just a moment at nighttime because it's creepier that way. But what I really like about this creation the most is all of the little nooks and crannies in the facade of the building. I like the use of the half steps and the stair slabs to make all of those little holes that kind of just give it so much character. It gives it so much attention to detail. I just can't get over the fact that it actually looks like a legitimate cathedral. I know that there have been other cathedrals before, but this one has that fantasy touch that I really want out of a creation like this. I mean, the dragons kind of look okay. I think if there's one thing that's holding this build back, actually I think there's two things. One, there's a few sloppy pieces, and what I mean by that is, floating above the cathedral is a line of blocks, of dirt blocks. It looks like someone went up there to finish building something and forgot to delete them, and there's a few signs here and there that shouldn't be there. For example, one sign telling the creators to give this so-and-so credit for building a hidden room within the angel statue. Stuff like that that just kind of got left, and they forgot to clean it up before they turned this into a world to download. And the other thing, I think the dragons, I like the fantasy touches, I do, but there's a few too many of these dragon statues, but that's just my personal opinion. I feel like they were just kind of added kind of willy-nilly. It doesn't seem like they have much rhyme or reason to be there. The angel statues themselves fit far more than I think than the dragon statues. And now we're seeing the Angel of Death there at night holding his scythe, and we're going to move on now to the end of this video and just give you another overlook of the front of the building here in just a moment. It is beautiful at night, everything is lit up, and it looks okay. There's one other thing. I'm watching the video as I'm commentating this and I almost forgot. This is a strange tree, isn't it? It's supposed to be some kind of tree of life, but it feels like it's missing a lot of green. Like, it feels like the leaves are kind of missing, like it's a dying tree of life. I don't know. That's the one other thing I would say that doesn't fit. But anyways, guys, hopefully you enjoyed this video. I want to know what you think about this particular build in the comments below, so feel free to leave a rating out of 5, so 1 being bad, 5 being amazing, in the comments below. I would look forward to seeing what you guys think about it, or, you know, feel free to leave more wordy comments on things that you think could be improved and what you enjoyed about this build the most. Take a look below in the description of this video to download it for yourself. Thank you guys for watching. My name is Etalyx, and I will see you next time.